Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I am going to explain you CLA means carry look ahead adder. So from name itself, you can understand what is the meaning of it. Carry look ahead. So here we will be predicting the carry. We will be looking ahead towards carry. And why we need to have that prediction of carry? The reason is, if you see my previous video based on serial adder, in that I have explained that addition is happening serially, and because of serial addition, that addition was slow. If you see that serial addition, then you see here this full adder that is generating carry, which is given to this full adder, and output of this full adder that is possible only if this full adder is generating carry. Now generated carry by this full adder that is given to this full adder. So output of this full adder S2 that is possible only if this carry is given by this full adder. So serially carry is rippled to the full adder in this direction, and because of that serial execution is happening, that was slower, right? And to resolve that issue of speed, we will be using CLA means carry look ahead adder, that is also referred as parallel adder. So in CLA, what we are doing is we are predicting the carry. Like you see, previously this full adder was waiting for this C0 carry from this full adder. This full adder was waiting for carry C1 from this full adder. Now here we will be predicting all the carries, this C0, C1, C2, C3 in advance. And because of that, you can say at a same time, all the carries are given to the full adder, and that will be resulting into output. So you can say that is parallel execution. Right, here this execution is serial execution, but as if all the carries are available and if answer is coming simultaneously, then you can say that is what? Parallel addition, right? So CLA, that is also referred as parallel adder. So this CLA, that is carry look ahead adder, that is also referred as parallel adder. Let us see the basics of CLA first. So in CLA, we add all the bits simultaneously, right? By predicting the carry well in advance. If we predict, or you can say if we look ahead carry, then simultaneous addition is possible, and that is also referred as parallel addition, right? CLA adds carry with independent number of bits to be added. See, in serial addition, that addition time, that was depending on number of bits, right? If you have 4 bits, if you have 4 bits, so in that situation, that carry that was getting transferred serially, right? And if you have 8 bits, in that case obviously it will take more time to have transfer of carry serially. But here with CLA, with carry look ahead adder, with parallel adder, you don't transfer carry serially. Here we predict all the carries at the same time, and because of that, execution time of addition is independent on number of bits, right? So if you have more number of bits, still execution time of addition is independent on number of bits, right? That's why we say this addition is very fast. Now what I'll do is I'll explain you one practical example of addition, and that practical example of addition that we will implement in terms of Boolean expression, and at last, based on those Boolean expression, I'll make a circuit of CLA, right? So let us have first simple example of addition. So here what I'll be doing is I'll be taking 2 numbers which is having size of 4 bits. Let us say A and B, that is how 2 numbers are there with us. So as A and B, that is having size of 4 bits, let us consider A with 4 bits as per A0, A1, A2 and A3, and B as per B0, B1, B2 and B3. Right, now let us add these 2 numbers. So as if you want to add these 2 numbers, obviously first you will be adding A0 and B0. So addition is resulting into sum over here. So sum is S0 over here, and carry of this, let us say that is C0 over here. Now next time when you want to have S1, at that time you'll have to add these 3 lines, right? C0, A1 and B1. That is resulting into S1, and it will be generating carry. Let us say that is C1 over here. Now, to have sum S2, you need to add C1, A2, B2. That will be generating sum S2, and it will be generating carry C2 over here. And once you add these 3 bits, you will be having sum S3 and output carry, that is C out over here. So that is how simply we can perform basic addition. Here I have considered 4 bits, right? Here you can have any number of bits, but for simplicity, and I can draw that 4 bit circuit over here easily, that's why I have considered this example. Now let us try to understand first how inputs and outputs are there, right? So if you observe, these are my inputs, right? This A0, B0, A1, B1, A2, B2, A3, B3, that is how inputs are there, right? And here, as if I want to make this circuit using full adder, then here I need to give one more input, let us say that is Cin, and that should be 0 ideally, right? So Cin, that is what also one input to be considered, as if you make this circuit using full adder, and I'm going to make this circuit using full adder, that's why I'm considering one more input Cin, and that will be 0 initially. So with black color, all the inputs are there, and with blue color, we are having outputs, right? So this carry and this sum. So all those data are outputs, right? Now, my dear students, our agenda is to predict the carry, right? So for carry prediction, what we need to do? We need to understand what is the Boolean expression of carry for full adder. Why? The reason is this entire circuit that I'll be making with the usage of full adder only. So first of all, you should know what is full adder, how carry expression is there. So in my previous video, I have already explained how full adder is there. Let me show you it over here. You see full adder that I have explained completely, and in that we have derived that carry expression. So that is AB plus AC in plus BC in, right? So this expression that I'll be using for prediction of carry, I'll explain you everything in steps so that you can have fair enough idea about how exactly things are happening. So you should see this video step by step. Definitely you'll get to know like how exactly all those things are happening, right? So first of all, you should know what is this Boolean function. So that Boolean function that I'll be using for a prediction of carry. So let me mention that Boolean function over here. So as if you want to predict the carry, first of all, you should know what is this Boolean function. So instead of A0, B0, A1, B1, in general, I'm writing this. So AB plus AC in plus BC in, that is how this Boolean expression is there. Now, let me simplify this Boolean expression first, right? So you see AB plus, now C in is there, and in bracket, now I'm writing A plus B. So that is how I can simplify this Boolean expression. Now, my dear students, if you observe this AB, that term, that is my input. So you don't need to predict input, right? As well as this C in, that is also my input. So I don't need to predict inputs. Input will be given. What we need to predict? We need to predict C0, C1, C2. So what I'll be doing is, I'll be making Boolean expressions. You see how? Instead of AB, now I'll be writing G, and instead of A plus B, I'll be writing P. Let us say G is generator and P is propagation, right? Now, my dear students, here I'll explain you how we can predict carry in sequence, right? So first of all, you don't need to predict C in, right? That is my input. So I'm writing C in over here. That is 0 initially. But now I need to predict C0. So what should be my C0? That C0, that should be based on A0, B0, right? So instead of A0 dot B0, I'll be writing G0 over here plus C in, that is my input. So I'm writing C in, I'm not writing that as 0. And instead of P, which is A plus B, now here we'll be having A0 plus B0, so that is P0, right? So C0 is getting predicted based on G0 and P0, right? Now what is G? G is A0 dot B0 and P is A0 plus B0. Now I need to predict C1. So let us try to understand how C1 will be there. So C1 will be as per, you see this C1 that is there based on A1 B1, right? So here instead of A1 B1, what I'll be doing is I'll be writing G1 plus C. Now here input is C0, so I need to write C0, and here P1, right? Now this G1, that is what based on A1 B1, A1 dot B1, and this P1 that is there based on A1 plus B1. But what is this C0? That is G0 plus C in P0. So I just need to substitute this over here. Now let us simplify this further. So this G1, that is first term plus second term, is this G0 into P1. So G0 into P1, and third term, that is plus C in into P0 P1, right? C in into P0 P1. So C1 is getting predicted based on this function. Now how to predict C2? So similar way is there. C2 will be, you see C2 will be based on A2 B2, A2 B2 dot, that is G2. So here I need to write G2 plus here this input carry is C1, right? A2 B2 and input carry is C1. So I need to write C1 here, and instead of A plus B, which is P, I need to write P2 over here. So here G2 plus, now C1 that we have calculated over here, let me write that, and into P2, don't not forget this, right? So now this G2 plus this G1 into P2, right? So I need to write G1 into P2 plus this G0 into P1 P2. So G0 into P1 P2, that I need to write, plus this C in into P0 P1 P2, that I need to write, right? Now what I need to do, I need to predict this C out carry, right? C2 that we have predicted as per this calculation. Now C out, that we need to predict. Now C out, that is happening based on what? C out is happening based on A3 B3. So instead of A3 dot B3, I need to write G3 over here. So I'm writing G3 over here, plus instead of this C in, now with A3 B3, carry is C2. So let me write C2 over here, and this dot P, that will be now P3 over here, right? Now what is C2? C2 we have simplified. Let me copy it over here. So let us simplify this. So G3 plus G2 into this P3 plus this G1 into P2 P3 plus G0 into P1 P2 P3 plus C in into P0 P1 P2 P3. So this is my C out function, right? So here, my dear students, we are predicting carries as per these functions, right? And here we are not predicting inputs. Inputs will be given over here, right? That will be A0 B0, A1 B1, A2 B2, and A3 B3, right? As well as C in. You see this C in, this C in, that will be my input, as well as A0 B0, A1 B1, A2 B2, A3 B3. That is how inputs will be there. All these carries, this C0, C1, C2, and C out, that we will be predicting as per this G1 P1, G0 P0, G2 P2, and G3 V3, right? Now based on this, let me explain you how exact circuit will be there, right? So instead of all this circuit, all these boolean functions, I'm just writing in this red box as carry look ahead, or you can say carry prediction. So here this box that is predicting carry as per this functions, right? The reason is if you make circuit of these functions, it will be a huge circuit, right? So instead of that, let me make it as a box over here. Now in this boxes, I'll be using full adder. So you see here I'm using this boxes as full adder, and with this boxes of full adder, what we will be giving, we'll be giving inputs. So with this first box, my inputs will be A0 B0. With this second full adder, my inputs, that will be A1 B1. With this third full adder, my inputs, that will be as per A2, B2. And with this fourth box, my inputs, that will be A3, B3. Right, that is how, first of all, my inputs are there. And you should know, my dear students, I have already told you. See, in this addition, my CIN is also my input, right? Here, this C0, C1, C2, that we are predicting. But CIN, that is my input. And that will be input to this first full adder. So, you see, this CIN, that is my input, right? This CIN, that is my input. That is 0 practically, but still, that is my input. And with this carry prediction, if you observe, with this carry prediction, see, with this C0, we are having CIN. With this C1, we are having CIN. With this C2, we are having CIN. So, this CIN, that should be also given to the this carry prediction logic, right? Now, my dear students, what I'll be doing is, I'll be explaining you how output is coming, right? So, with this full adder 1, what is my output? Sum S1, right? Not S1, sum S0, right? You see, with this, sum is S0. With this, sum is S1, right? So, here, S0, that is my sum. Here, S1, that is my sum of this full adder. Here, S2, that is my sum. And here, S3, that is my sum. Now, how exactly those carries are predicted? So, this carry prediction logic, that will be predicting carry, right? So, you see, this C0, that is predicted by this carry prediction. And this C0, that will be given to next full adder, right? So, C0, that is predicted over here, and it will be given to this full adder. The C1, that is predicted over here, and that will be given to this full adder. The C2, that is predicted over here, and that will be given to this full adder. And C out, that is my output, right? C out. But how we can predict this? For that, you see, I have written G0, P0. What is G0? G0 is A0 dot B0. P0, that is A0 plus B0. So, that G0 and P0, that will be generated by this full adder. And that will be given to this carry prediction. And carry prediction is having this Boolean equations, right? So, here, G0 and P0, that will be given by this full adder. Now, you see, here we have G1, P1. So, that G1, P1, that will be generated by this full adder. So, G1 and P1, that will be generated by this full adder, right? G2, P2, that is generated by this full adder. And G3, P3, that will be generated by this full adder. So, here, my final output, that is this C out and this sum. Right. And my dear students, here that carry is not propagating serially. If you observe all these functions, right, this G1, G0, P0, G1, P1, G2, P2, as well as this CIN, that is my input, right? That is my input. And based on that, at the same time, the C0, C1, C2, C that is getting generated, right? So all the carries, this C0, C1, C2 and C out, that is getting generated at the same time. And that prediction is happening as per this Boolean equation, right? So, I have derived all the Boolean equation as well as I have explained you how exactly we can have formation of this circuit. I hope it is clear to you. Still, if anything that would like to share it with me, please note it down in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.